Hello everybody, today we'll upgrade the mini PC that we bought for under 10,000 rupees. We will add 16GB of RAM and a higher capacity SSD. We will also install an excellent piece of software for the SSD. This will speed up the disk throughput to beyond the ordinary numbers. This in turn will justify our choice of the RAM capacity and the brand of SSD. Even if you are not planning to buy the mini PC, this video should help you with making the right choice when upgrading your SSD. We'll also let you know a trick to speed up your current SSD, probably of any brand. Let's get into it right now. We reviewed the low-cost mini computer in our previous video. We found it to be pretty quick. We saw that it could play 3 1080p tracks simultaneously. That makes it a decent performer for multi-track video editing. But when we tried to render the output video, the computer was consistently complaining about low RAM. While we were able to hit the ignore button and render the video, we were wondering if it would be faster with more RAM, and that's why it's upgrade. Evaluation is always the first step in the upgrade process. We want to get it right so that there's enough headroom for high-end applications. The scope for further upgradation is left open, and the money for upgradation is spent well. As with RAM, we used a command and found that the mini PC's motherboard supports up to 64GB of RAM. But since the processor supports only 32GB and the fact that the processor is soldered out of the motherboard, the maximum we can go up to is 32GB of RAM. 2 16GB RAMs is the ideal upgrade option. The processor has dual channel memory feature, and using 2 RAMs instead of 1 will result in slightly higher memory bandwidth. We will add only 1 16GB for now to save the cost and leave open the option of adding another 16GB in future when applications demand more. As with the SSD, we went with the 240GB Crucial Budget Series SSD. Hardware-wise, there is nothing special with the SSD. It does not have any onboard DRAM either. But what makes it special is the software that comes along with it. The application is called Momentum Cache, and it allows a portion of the RAM to speed up the SSD, particularly the write speed, and most importantly, the smaller 4K read and write speeds, which result in ultra-fast browsing experience. With this, practically the processor is transacting a majority of the instantaneous data from the RAM instead of the SSD. The RAM, as we know, is many times quicker than even the fastest SSDs. Another added benefit is that it prolongs the life of the SSD. Momentum Cache, according to the specifications, will allot a maximum of up to 25% of available RAM. Also, it is limited to a maximum of 4GB. So it is clear why we chose 16GB RAM as our upgrade for our computer. 25% of 16GB is 4GB, and we want Momentum to work in maximum capacity. Samsung also has a similar software for a few of its SSDs and is called Samsung Rapid, but the allotted RAM is restricted to a maximum of 1GB, which is quite less than the Momentum's 4GB. So our choice of SSD brand was clear and well justified. Besides, we got our SSD for 2000 rupees, which pretty much was a bargain. We don't get Samsung SSDs for anywhere close to that price. Adding the new RAM is a fairly straightforward process. We opened the 4 screws at the bottom of the mini PC and located the empty DIMM. We aligned the notch on the RAM to the one on the slot and gently pushed it down to lock it in place. It is as simple as that. The original 4GB RAM that came along with the mini PC was left there as it is. Now we have a total of 20GB RAM. The 4GB RAM was clocked at 2400 MHz. Although the crucial memory is 2666 MHz, it will clock down to 2400 MHz to match the other RAM. Besides, our processor supports a maximum of 2400 MHz only. One important thing about crucial RAM is that it is available in two different variants, the FRA variant and the SFS variant. It is recommended to choose the FRA variant since it has higher memory bandwidth. SFS sells for 50 rupees less, but that's a negligible price difference. Installing the SSD would require some work up front. We need to clone the existing SSD to the new one. We will use a trusted dual HDD dock to do this job. Just put the Windows SSD in the source slot and the new SSD in the target slot. Hit the copy button and the cloning will be completed in a few minutes, as it is just 60GB. If a dock is unavailable, we can use Acronis True Image or CloneZilla to do the same. It is not at all hard and fairly self-explanatory. Let's drop in the new SSD and boot our machine. Opening up the task manager will show more RAM, 20 GB in our case. We can see the indication that both the DIMMs are filled as well. Move over to the SSD and we see that it shows only 60 GB instead of 240 GB that we installed. The reason is that we cloned a 60 GB drive. Let's open up Windows Disk Management and resize the drive to cover the entire 240 GB. Great, that's all we need to initialize. Let's benchmark the SSD with Crystal Disk Mark. The figures are good alright, but did we forget that we wanted it just not to be good, but actually spectacular? Let's welcome Momentum. We downloaded the Crucial Storage Executable tool, installed it and turned on the Momentum Cache feature. Now let's test the disk speed again. Bingo! That is crazy quick! Quicker than even the M.2 NVMe SSDs. The 4K performance is even better. Now that's money well spent for a worthy upgrade. Couple of important things that we wanted to tell you before concluding this video. Momentum Cache works with the operating system partition only, so keeping everything as a single C drive is beneficial. Lastly, here's a useful terrific hack. If we install and enable Momentum on a Crucial SSD, then clone the drive to another SSD of a different brand, Momentum Cache will continue to work fine. Now that's a useful tip. Use it. Have fun and have a great day. This is Arjun and Vishnu signing off. Thank you.